Hello! In today's video, we are going to be talking about how many meals a day do you really need? Now, this can honestly apply to fat loss, maintenance, muscle building, all of the above. I'm kind of focusing a little more on fat loss here, but really, just you'll know. I'll go into like little details as we explain. So back in the day, there was this common myth that you had to eat 6 small meals or every 2 hours in order to keep your metabolism burning and lose weight more efficiently. That's not true. I do know there's still some people that believe that, but we've kind of shifted to the opposite side of the spectrum, and a lot of people are doing intermittent fasting type eating where they have the opposite. So instead of eating every few hours, they're eating a couple large meals in a smaller chunk of time. So which one is better? Well, when it comes to meal timing, there's 2 essential factors that you want to have down pat. The timing of your meals, they have to be easy for you to stick to and make you feel satisfied and energized. So that means, like for me, when I tried eating 6 small meals a day, I felt terrible. I always felt hungry. I always felt deprived because I like eating bigger meals. So if I just had this tiny little 1 out of 6 meals, like I hated it. It made my binge eating so much more of a struggle. I prefer a more intermittent fasting type approach. While I don't stick to it rigidly and have like, oh, a specific eating window, a cutoff time, a start at this time, blah, 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 I do like more of the style of a few big meals a day. So what does that mean? It means that whatever you do for eating, honestly, at the end of the day, meal timing is just such a minuscule portion of your results. So choose whatever is going to be easiest for you to stick to. I'll get people saying, oh, I have a hard time eating healthy because I'm really, really busy and I just don't have time to stop and keep eating or prepare that food. And that's the good news. You could literally eat 2 large meals a day, maybe a couple snacks earlier, and still see results. Like you could eat 3 meals and a snack, 4 meals and a snack, 6 meals, like whatever you want, whatever makes you feel satisfied and doesn't feel like it's taking away from your workouts is what you want to do. Now, when it comes to maintaining muscle or building muscle, it does help a little bit to spread your protein sources fairly evenly throughout the day. Now, that's not the same thing as like, oh, 6 small meals. No, it's better for your muscles. You get better muscle protein synthesis when your protein is separated a little bit. You don't have to take it to the extreme. Some studies do say that 5 different portions of protein is really good. I usually just stick to 3 to 4. So I'm gonna explain how I structure my day to get those extra little servings of protein in without eating small frequent meals. So what I'll do is I wake up really early, 4 or 5 a.m. and around 10 a.m. I'll have a protein shake. Then shortly, a little while after that, I'll work out. And then when I get home, I'll have my first big meal. So that's my second feeding of protein. And then I'll have like some sort of dinner-y type thing a few hours later. And that'll be my third protein serving. And then maybe, depending on how I'm feeling, just later on, I'll have like something more enjoyable and exciting, like maybe some type of high protein, macro friendly treat, like protein ice cream, Greek yogurt with cereal, who knows? I'll have something like that. So really that ends up being 4 different protein feedings for the day, but just 3 big meals. So that helps me feel more satisfied because all my big meals are kind of closer together towards the end of the day. But I'm still getting that nice little start of protein to kind of feed myself before my workout. Sometimes I'll have a little small something of carbs too. Just small, could be a little like half a banana, just something like. And that's the thing as well. If you are doing like strict intermittent fasting, I used to work out first thing in the morning when I was kind of following that approach, and I would work out fasted, and I felt fine, to be honest. So I think, again, it just comes down to listening to your body. If you try that and you just feel like your workouts are really, really suffering, then have like some sort of little snack or a meal, just something, because the fasting itself isn't gonna make you burn more fat. What it does is simply just reduces the time that you're eating. So it makes it easier to create a caloric deficit. So yeah. So if you are someone who always has done small frequent meals or kind of like little meals with a lot of snacks and you have a hard time staying on track, you might want to at least just try with the more bigger spaced out meals and just see how you feel. It might take a little bit to get used to, so give it a little bit of time. But I have had so many clients who were struggling because they came into the coaching being like, I really like having small frequent meals. And I was like, okay. And then they, after some time passed, and they were like, you know what, I'm having a hard time staying on track. And I said, well, why don't you try structuring your meals like this? And it helped. So yeah, it's definitely worth a try. And I think another thing that helps is just paying attention to if you're someone who like struggles with falling off track, which I'm pretty sure most people do from time to time, nobody's perfect. Look at those situations. So basically for me, like I mentioned earlier, I would struggle with falling off track more at night. That's when I'd get more cravings. That's when I would get hungrier. So I noticed that and I thought, okay, I think it makes sense to save more calories for the evening because that's when I struggle the most. So if there's a specific time where you feel you struggle a little more, maybe it's not even like at the end of the day, maybe it's like middle of the day, maybe when you, or like early evening, maybe when you get home from work, you're starving and you always have a hard time controlling yourself, then save a big portion of your calories for that time. And maybe even to hold yourself over for that, you could even have like a tiny little snack on your way home from work, just anything. Like, you just really gotta look at yourself, what your struggles are, when you tend to fall off track, when you tend to have more cravings, and then structure your meals around that. So there's no like definitive rules. It's not like, oh, you have to eat this. Like, I'll get people saying, oh, I really hate breakfast, I know I should eat it. And I'm like, no, you don't. You really don't. I used to wake up starving, and I actually trained myself out of that. So yeah. Also remember that you don't have to stick to just one type of meal structure. Listen to your body. Maybe some days you'll feel like you need a little snack in between, or maybe sometimes you'll even just go through periods of time where your work schedule or just various things in your life make you want to shift to a different way of eating. So just always know that it can change, and that at the end of the day, you just want to be hitting your calories and your protein and making sure you feel good. Of course, you aren't feeling like crappy and low energy during your workouts, but as long as all those things are in line, you're good to go, and you can time your meals however you would like. So hopefully that helps you guys a little bit. If you were thinking that you had to eat one specific way, just because something works for someone else doesn't mean it's the most optimal for you. And that is all. So if you enjoyed this video, like and subscribe, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!